Freedom Biker Church of Monroe. We got it on the back of our shirts. Come as you are, and we'll love hell out of you.
Amen.
Until you show a person that you love them, it doesn't matter what you have to say. I actually stole that slogan from somebody else. He told me one day, he had an old man telling him, said, if you really want to see people get saved, you got to love the hell out of them. Think about it. You literally do. Because if you don't love them, it don't matter. That's one thing about our church. I'm very cautious to say my church. Because it ain't mine, it's God's church.
Amen.
They love each other. It's not to say we're perfect, but we do love each other. I ask them regularly, who are you praying for? Who's in your family? Who's your closest friends? That if Jesus came back today, that you would spend eternity without them because you didn't live the life that Jesus required of you. I'm not saying living a perfect life because ain't none of us perfect. Another slogan we use, sinners are welcome, all others are tolerated. Some of you catch that in a minute. How many people have you met spent in church all their life that literally thought that they didn't sin, they lived a perfect life? Folks, I'm here to tell you, I feel like Paul so much of the time. Paul said, of all sinners, I am the worst. Until we realize how big a sinner we are and how sorry we are in our own ways, there's no way we can draw closer to the Father. Told Wide Load I wouldn't have long to speak. I don't think I got a whole lot more. There's another thing that Paul said over in Romans, which is chapter 10. He said, it's my heart's desire that all of Israel would be saved. My question to you today, what is your heart's desire? My heart's desire is to see all bikers get saved.
Amen.
Is that going to happen? No, it's not. That's my heart's desire. I love motorcycles and I love bikers. Started riding when before I was 16. I started on dirt bikes. My first vehicle was a motorcycle. Since then, I love many of you can say the same thing. You started out as a little kid, grew up with it. Folks, I hope that every one of you here is on your way to heaven. The ticket's already been purchased. It's already been paid for. But you got to receive it.
Amen.
I want you to do some soul searching. If Jesus came back today, would you be getting on with him? Would you be going with him back to heaven? Revelation tells us that if he's coming, comes back, he's riding on a white horse. My interpretation of that verse is, when that sky busts wide open, it's coming back on a white Ultra Classic. Are you ready to ride with him?
Yeah.
Will he be taking you along in the parade? Or will you be sitting back watching? I want to ask you, think about one person in your life, whether it be a friend or a family member, that you want to see come to Jesus this year. Keep that person on your mind. Here in just a minute, we're going to close this thing out. I know somebody's tired of sitting, tired of waiting. But it's really pretty simple. To get people motivated to share Jesus Christ with other people, you've got to have Jesus Christ in your life. When he's in your life, nobody will have to ask you to read your Bible and pray every day. There's going to be days that you're not going to feel like praying. There's going to be days that you don't feel like reading your Bible. I do that. But as brothers and sisters, I should be close enough to God to know when he's having a bad day and he don't feel like praying, I need to be praying for him and lift him up. Are you that close with anybody? Or do you still hang on to your old biker lifestyle that says, I can do it on my own? Folks, you can't do it on your own. We'll close this thing out with some of the words that got it started. Without love, where would you be now? Because Jesus loved you, Jesus loved me enough, he's indescribable. He laid down his life on that cross. They didn't force him down on it. He gave it up. He gave it to them because of love. Folks, we need to love one another. And when we go to these rallies, we need to quit acting like my bike patch is better than yours. We do things better than you do. It takes all of the body of Christ.
Amen.
Doing its individual part to make the body complete.
Amen.
The Sheridan wide load. Paul says in 1 Corinthians chapter, I believe it's 5 or 6, some plant, some water, some harvest, but God is the one that gives the increase.
Amen.
Without God, everything's done for nothing. So don't shun one another when you're out of here. Lift each other and pray for each other every day. I don't care what backpack you wear.
Amen.
Personally, I don't wear one. God told me not to. I used to. He told me not to put one back on that I didn't need it. Don't be a bumper sticker Christian. Live what you talk.
Amen.
Then you will see people coming to Jesus because it's not what you say. They see it coming out of you. They come out of your life. They'll be coming to you. What's different about you? Why are you so happy? Trust me, it'll happen if you get the number one priority in order first. We're going to close this out. I want to ask you to keep in mind that person that you want to pray for, that you want to see come to Jesus this year. I'm going to ask you to come down here around the front. The best way we can kick off a year is on our knees. I'm going to ask you to come on.